also from Sanusi Latif. Like I said earlier, we'll be looking at what actually started this whole face-off between SANU, that is the Senior Staff Association of Nigerian Universities, and the management of the Federal University of Agriculture, Abeokuta, FUNAAB, or let's say the person of the Vice Chancellor, Professor Ojewole, who has been at the receiving end of allegations, and of course the call for the either suspension or stepping down, as it were, from the SANU members to the Vice Chancellor. The management actually took a decision, which was to sack 23 non-teaching members of staff in their own bid, in their words, to reposition the university and restore peace on campus. This was greeted with mixed reactions, as a lot of people felt that this was some move that was aimed at cowing and intimidating the SANU members, who have been actually calling the attention of EFCC and the federal government, or the president, Muhammadu Buhari himself, personally, to the alleged misappropriation of funds and mismanagement of resources at the university. According to the head directorate of public relations, Mrs. Amy Alawade, she said the staff were sacked for stealing of university property, insubordination, and willful disobedience to lawful instructions. Those were the words of the head directorate of public relations. Well, we have someone who will speak for SANU in the studio, and I think I'll be looking at all these issues together. I have with me, or we have with us in the studio, Comrade Abdulsabur. Abdulsalam Abdulsabur. Thank you for joining us on the show.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
All right, let us quickly start from the genesis of this. What exactly started or created this unfortunate situation that we find on our plate at FUNAAB?
Well, I want to first and foremost thank you for acknowledging that the situation we find ourselves at the Federal University of Agriculture, Abeokuta, is indeed very unfortunate. Very unfortunate, a very sad and disappointing situation we find ourselves. But that is the reality. We cannot run away from the situation, but to see how we can remedy it. And that's why we are doing all we can within our own means, all legal means possible, to ensure that the situation is remedied. Well, this problem started, I would say, early this year. But of course, the problem had been on ground for more than 3 years. It had actually been festering. And that is actually a function and a product of the mismanagement of the university in terms of welfare, in terms of relationship with staff, in terms of management of staff affairs, particularly when it has to do with members of the Senior Staff Association of Nigerian Universities, SANU. We find a very unfortunate situation where we are relegated to appear as if, because we are non-teaching staff in the university, we are nothing. Our promotions, in over 100 people, only 20 people are given. And what it, of course, turns out to create is a situation of disgruntlement, a situation of unhappiness, a situation of apathy to the system. Now, coming specifically to where we are today, well, I want to say that the matter itself, the direct matter, started about early this year when the bosser, the former bosser, Mr. Moses Ilesome, decided to request for an extension of 1 year to his term in line with the law. There is a law that says you are entitled to 5 years as a bosser or as a registrar, and then 1 year, which is discretionary. It is at the discretion of the governing council of the university. It is not automatic. We do not, if the council chooses in its wisdom to say, look, we are not giving him, there's nothing anybody can do. But unfortunately, what we find out in the Federal University of Agriculture, Abeokuta, is a very crude organization. The council is crude, the management is crude. I say it without any apologies to anybody. A situation where, yes, you have a right to say this man is not entitled to it. And you tell him, gentlemen, you have done well for the system, you can go. I mean, that is what it should be. But even government, even when somebody has, you want to discharge somebody from government, you write him a letter, you appreciate him, and you tell him, we appreciate your services, you can go. That's what you should do. But unfortunately, what the vice chancellor and the council of the university, the chairman of council, chose to do was to allude to the stealing of a 27 million naira by the bossa. A thing that never happened, something that was just a creation of the figment of their imagination. We have the evidences, we have the documents. I don't want to go into all the details of it. But if you want me to, what happened was that in 2011, when the university was expanding, between 2010 and 2011, when the university was growing, they decided to have a liaison office at Abuja. And in choosing to have a liaison office in Abuja, they decided to advertise to see if they could get people who were interested in renting out their property in Abuja. And at the end of the day, they got somebody who chose to lease his property for about 27 million for 2 years, 27 million naira. And at the end of the day, that property agreed upon between the university and that person. At the point of the university paying the 27 million naira to that person, after about 1 month of negotiation, of course, it started from like 40 million, 50 million, before they now struck a deal at 27 million naira. At the point of paying that money, the money was paid, they collected the keys to the property, a leasing office in Abuja, only for them to discover that the person who had sold that property, who had leased that property, had actually sold the property to another person. I don't know if you get the picture. He had sold the property to another person.
So that means the person leasing it does not have legal right to deal with, or to transact
exactly
any business with that.
Now, at the end of the day, the decision to buy that property was a decision of council. It was a decision of the former council and the former vice chancellor. It wasn't a decision of the bossa. The bossa's responsibility is to pay the money, is to release the money on approval.
Is this person we are talking about the bossa or the former VC?
That's what I'm saying.
The owner of the house, the person,
who owns the house, is a politician.
Okay.
He's somebody who is removed from the university. He's a politician. So he just duped the university or fraudulently obtained money from the university. And the university contested it, took it to the Federal High Court. This case was won at the Federal High Court. And the man still feels that he hasn't stolen anything from the university. The university tarried before paying and all of that. And at the end of the day, the matter is now at the Court of Appeal. But the university won in the first instance at the High Court. Now, at the end of the day, you now alluded to a 27 million naira deal gone bad that had happened since 2011 as a reason why you will not give this man a renewal of appointment. A 27 million naira that the bossa did not approve to himself.
Comrade Sabu, you
yes
said two things while making your statement.
Yes.
That the decision to agree with an extension or not lies in the council, which
yes
is also discretionary.
Yes.
Yes. Now, for whatever reason that is,
yes,
one person does not make the council.
Yes.
And the decision was taken by the council.
Yes.
So why are you now fighting individuals over a decision taken by a group?
Nobody has fought individuals. Now let me give you the picture. The picture is, yes, the council exists, but the council is made up of people who rely on the vice chancellor for information. And in 90% of the cases, it is where the vice chancellor wants a council to go that he goes, that the whole council goes.
I understand there was a meeting last week or about 2 weeks ago with the chairman of council in Lagos. Were you part of that meeting?
No. They have been calling meetings. I've never been part of their meetings.
So when I say you, I'm talking of your group, SSANU.
SSANU has never been invited for any meeting with any management of the university in the last 2 months. We have tried, sent messages, written letters requesting
for audience with the Vice Chancellor, he has locked every, sealed every means of accessibility to him.
Let me also ask you, you said this crisis has been first screened since 2013.
Yes.
If you calculate, that's almost immediately Professor Yewole assumed office as the Vice Chancellor.
Yes.
And then there are stories that this is political, that he's been fought by your group who do not want him as the man to succeed Professor Balogun.
Well, that is, you see, I want to tell you that we should not reduce serious matters to politics. As far as I'm concerned, like I was ruminating on my way here, I said, I was just thinking about this whole thing because I've had journalists ask me the same question. And I tell myself, when Olisametu and some of these politicians, I'm not a politician, I don't belong to APC or PDP, but when Olisametu, the Dasukis of this world, when they were first invited, when the allegations first started flying, the first insinuation was, this is politics, this is politics, this is politics. But by the time revelations started coming out, it showed that it was no longer politics, it was reality. And the same way, if Buhari's government should leave today, or it should leave whenever it is due to leave, maybe in 4 years' time or 10 years' time or whenever, some people will also be caught for stealing. And at the end of the day, they will also insinuate politics. So it is the way of people to try to divert attention from serious matters to now go the way it is politics. It is political. No. There's nothing political. For us, the issue is a case of corruption. The Vice Chancellor and the council has opened itself to corrupt practices to the tune of 300 million naira, at least with evidences. This is the document. I present to you a document. I can hand it over to Rockcity FM if you want, with all the attachments of how the 300 million naira was allocated, shared amongst members of council. 300 million naira, I don't think that is negotiable.
So that is the crux of the...
That is where we are today.
Okay, now, before you took this case to the EFCC,
yes,
were there internal mechanisms put in place by the management or by your union to see if these issues of mismanagement could be scrutinized?
Well, let me say one thing. First and foremost, you do not report a thief to a thief.
Can you expatiate on
what that? I mean is that when you are talking of internal mechanisms,
okay,
I allege that you stole Toby, and then I come to you and I say, Toby, I want you to investigate how you stole money. It's not possible. The only, and that is why in the law, the agencies that are empowered to investigate cases of crime, cases of fraud, cases of corruption, are either the EFCC or the ICPC. And I think perhaps only recently, I don't know if the DSS has been also. But of course, what I'm saying is that at the end of the day, you don't report somebody who you are alleging of stealing to himself. What do you want him to say? I mean, if you report it to him, what do you want him to say? And so, this is a case of crime, for crying out loud.
You decided to approach the EFCC.
Yes.
So what happened after you approached the EFCC till this very moment?
Yes. Now, it was actually just like I told you, the case of the 27 million naira alleged to the bossa that actually drew our attention to a lot of other things that were going on in the university. And at the end of the day, by the time we looked at the colossal amounts of monies that had been disbursed among members of council, allocated to the chairman of council himself, Senator Adesheye Ogunlewe, and then the vice chancellor himself, we found ourselves in a position where we had to say, look, no, this cannot continue. This is our common patrimony. This is money we are talking about, government money. And beyond that, this is a university that is crying out for lack of funds. A university that is challenged. When you say, okay, we want promotions, you say there is no financial backing. And at the end of the day, you step down 50, 100 members of SANU's promotions annually. And then you now have a situation where, ordinarily by the rules, you should be promoted once every 3 years. You promote some people as long as 4 years, 5 years, as far as they are SANU members, on the grounds that there is no money. And then you now discover that 300 million naira has been stolen somewhere.
Comrade Abdulsabur, because you have to have a bit for the national news 10, we'll have to stop
a bit.
Yes, when we continue, I'll give you specific details of what we are talking about.
I also want you to tell us what exactly was the response you got from EFCC and why it seems that your allegations have not been treated, either discarded or otherwise, have not been treated with the kind of importance that it should be treated with if they truly are genuine. I hope you'll be able to tell us that. And then we'll be back. Stay with us. If you have any questions for the SSANU Comrade, just start sending them to 32120. Or if you're on Twitter, tweet us at RockcityFM is our Twitter handle. Stay with us.